And it was because his sons were scoundrels and rascals that the people said to Samuel, we don't want your sons to be our judges, our prophets anymore. No, we want a king like the other nations. We want a king. Samuel said, by asking for a king, you've rejected God. They said, we don't care. We want a king anyway. Because your sons, we don't want them to rule over us as you have. So Samuel anoints the first king of Israel, King Saul. And he was a good man for a while, but he was kind of one of these politicians that looked really good on the outside, but he didn't really have a good heart. He was a tall man, likely as tall as John or Chris. And it said that he was a handsome man. And he was head and shoulders above everyone else. He was also a warrior of sorts. And the people followed him. But you know, he didn't do what he was supposed to do in a battle by destroying everything. Instead, he kept out some of the best things for him. The best sheep, the best goats, probably the gold and the silver. And God said, no, you didn't do what I told you to do. When Lucy and I were driving back from Missouri this last week, there was a little hand-painted sign on a fence post I just happened to notice. It just, in handwriting, it said, obey God. That was it. Obey God. And that's the one thing that Saul wouldn't do. So, God sets Saul aside, and who's the next king? The greatest king of Israel, King David. The boy king, the shepherd king, the warrior king. Samuel was there to anoint him. You remember? Seven sons paraded before him, the sons of Jesse. And all of them looked great, fine-looking men. And God kept saying, nope. He's not the one. Nope, he's not the one. And so finally, they're all passed before Samuel, and Samuel says, well, there's got to be another son around. Oh yeah, there's this young son out in the fields taking care of the sheep. Go get him. We're not going to have supper until he comes. So David comes, and God says, this is the one. And God says to Samuel, people look on the outside appearance of a person's life, but God looks inside the soul. He looks at the heart. And you remember in the book of Acts in chapter 13, it says there that David was a man after God's own heart. What a compliment. To be a man or a woman after God's own heart, that was David's compliment. Samuel got to see that. And at the end of his life, when Samuel dies, all the people mourned over him. And then comes one more piece about Samuel's life that's a very interesting piece. So by this time, King Saul is hanging on. Try to be king, and you remember all these years he's hounded David, trying to kill him because he knew that David was anointed to be king in his place. But Samuel didn't step aside, as his son Jonathan did, for David to be king. And so he goes to this medium, this spiritist woman called the Witch of Endor. It's a very curious chapter in the end of 1 Samuel. And Saul says, you know, do some kind of a seance and get Samuel up from the dead and you can talk to him. And she somehow pulls him up from the dead. This shadowy figure comes up and Samuel says to Saul, why have you disturbed me? Saul says, I'm worried. You know, our enemies are surrounding us and I'm afraid for my life. Samuel says, God has rejected you as being king over Israel. He's chosen David who will be a better king. And he said, by this time tomorrow, you and your sons will be with me. And the next day in battle, King Saul and his sons died in battle. Samuel had quite a story, quite a life to live. The readings this morning are about a call that God has on your life and mine. So God called Samuel by calling him verbally. Samuel, Samuel, think about it. Think if God called you in this way. John, Lucy, Nancy, Tom, Cleo, Bob, Chris, Van, Piper, Finn, Kiki, and our dear friend Ann. What would happen if God called each of you individually and said, I have a calling for you? Notice the gospel reading is the same story. God is calling Nathanael. Jesus is calling Nathanael. What kind of a call does God have on your life? What is your calling for life? Is it to have a job? Is it to raise a family? Oh, yes. But is there something more? Is there something more that God Maybe it's to be a dear friend to someone else that needs a friend. When I first moved to Aurora and moved out of the old farmhouse, a friend and I had just put in the wood stove, and it was November. It was getting to be cold. And John knew that I didn't have any firewood, apparently. And he said, I've got a truckload of firewood. Why don't I bring it out for you to get you started? That meant a lot to me. It was what a friend would do. I wanted to talk with you also about a man, briefly, that also dealt with kings. We have Samuel dealing with King Saul and King David. Have any of you heard the poet from the 17th century named George Herbert? He was a great English poet. I wanted to tell you a few things about him. Now, he had a signet ring on his hand. And do you know what was inscribed in that signet ring? It was this: less than the least of his mercies. Less than the least of his mercies. This is from a prayer that Jacob prayed in Genesis chapter 32 when his brother Esau was about ready to, what he thought, attack him the next day. And he said, oh God, be with me the least of your mercies. So George Herbert, the 17th century poet, took that and inscribed that in the signet ring that he wore every day of his life. What a man he was. And you know what? It was because of his mother that he became the man that he was. His father died when he was 3 years old. He became a university orator of Latin at Trinity College, Cambridge, by age 30. He was essentially the poet laureate of England before they had that title. In 1623, he was elected to Parliament. He dealt with kings. He was alive when King James I was King of England, and we have the King James Bible. In 1629, he married. But you know what? He was on an upward track. He was ready to go into the king's court for a high position in the palace. And then he did something that was highly unusual for all of us. He decided to go the other way and take the downward mobility